This week, we're talking about atmosphere, the magic ingredient to any successful work of art, right after this. Hi, the Inspired Actor here. If you're new to this channel, we are dedicated to helping actors become better artists by offering these quick, roughly 10-minute acting lessons. Just a quick reminder, we have about 50 of these on our channel so far, so check them out if you want. And if you want to see more videos like these, go ahead and subscribe so you'll be notified as soon as they come out. Also, take a moment before you forget and hit that like button, as it really helps me out. And if you know people who might like these videos, please don't hesitate to share them on your social media outlet of choice. The atmosphere of every piece of art is its heart. It's feeling soul. Michael Chekhov. Imagine you are on stage right now. What do you see around you? There's you, of course, your body and your costume. There are your fellow actors on stage with you. There's the furniture and various set pieces and props. There's the scenery and the walls of the set. Above you are the stage lights. In front of you or around you is the audience. Way in the back is the wall of the theater and the doors of the house. Now let's open your imagination to your other senses. What do you hear? Perhaps a line spoken by your fellow actor. The rustle of programs from the audience. The breathing of many people sitting in the dark. There's the smell of makeup and dust made hot by the stage lights. There's the feel of the stage beneath you and the warmth of the lights above you. Is that all? There are probably more images that are in your imagination that I haven't mentioned. Recognize them as well and allow yourself to imagine them fully and with as much specificity as possible. Now that you have a picture in your mind of all the tangible things that you may experience when you are on stage, and boy, don't we miss it, I would like to invite you to imagine things that are not so tangible. Things that you can't necessarily feel with your physical senses, but are no less there with you on this imaginary stage. So now let's imagine that all those tangible things are being stripped away. No more stage or scenery or audience. No more lights above you or smells around you or sounds from the darkness of the house. Everything you can see, hear, touch, and smell is gone. But one thing remains, the feeling of the stage. This feeling is not something that is easily described, but if you have ever been on stage, you know this feeling intimately. Perhaps this feeling instantly makes you feel excited or happy. Maybe it makes you feel terrified or anxious. However it makes you feel is entirely your own, but the feeling exists and it is generating energy inside of you. It may even make you want to do something physically, like take a bow or run for cover. This feeling is what Michael Chekhov was referring to when he talked about atmosphere, and it is one of the most vital and important elements that an actor must become aware of and use. If the mind or idea of the play or movie is the text, and the body of the play or movie are the actors, set, costumes, and all the other physical elements of the production, then the living soul of the play or movie is the atmosphere. We have all seen plays or movies that lacked a strong feeling of atmosphere. The acting was there, the story was solid, the special effects were expensive looking, and yet something about it didn't work. Something intangible made the sum less than the whole of its parts. That missing element, the atmosphere, separates mediocre or bad productions from great and inspired ones. This is because atmosphere doesn't merely exist behind the fourth wall of the stage, but permeates, radiates through the barrier between artist and spectator, deepening audience perceptions, emotional, physical, spiritual, and so on, and allowing them to feed back into the performance, which in turn deepens the artistic output of those performers and creates a strong artistic interchange between performance and audience, and elevating taking it beyond itself into a transcendent work of art. Oh, if you're confused by what I just said, hang on a minute. Later on in this video, I'll explain the creative process in a little more detail. Getting back to film, the exchange between performance and audience is more limited, but no less vital. Yes, the performance itself is now something that has already happened, but the work itself lives on as artistic output in much the same way a painting or a photograph might. Remember, we still call them moving or motion pictures. And just as with any work of art, without a strong atmosphere, it will not affect us in the way it may have intended, and it may seem dull and lifeless no matter how much money may have been sunk into it. I know this feels like poetry and maybe I'm going too far, but I have to tell you, once you become aware of atmosphere and how vital it is to any work of art, then you will be able to tell whether a show is going to be successful or not almost as soon as you walk into the door of the theater. Shows in which actors seem like they're all in separate plays, or shows that feel disconnected or inconsistent or just plain bland. These are shows that lack a strong feeling of atmosphere to connect the actors to each other and the ensemble to the audience. Michael Chekhov felt that atmosphere should be the first of his acting concepts that students are taught. He felt that atmosphere was the seed of the play, which contained the whole plant within. Understanding and being receptive to atmosphere is an essential step in working with this technique. So what exactly is atmosphere? Well, let's begin with music. Music is the easiest place to discover atmosphere because it is ingrained in us as humans to not only listen to the sounds, but to incorporate the feeling that a certain piece of music is trying to convey. But then I threw my caution to the wind. Some music is slow and some is fast. Some is loud while some is soft, but we tend to refer to songs as happy songs or sad songs, uplifting music or scary music, music that makes you want to dance and music that makes you want to meditate. Music itself is just a composition of notes played on instruments made of wood or metal. There is a math to music. And if I were an alien who never heard music before and found a piece of sheet music, there would be nothing there to make me feel anything. But once the music is played, then there can be a feeling to that music. And the greater the musician, the greater the artist making the music is, the more clearly that feeling is conveyed to the listener. The power of music to move us emotionally is unmistakable. That is why directors use it so freely in movies and plays as underscoring to the dialogue. Music helps make the feelings they want to convey to the audience clearer, and audiences in turn tend to open themselves up more to those feelings because it is deep within our nature as humans to listen to music not only with our ears, but with our hearts. So to put it another way, music is the art. The notes, the tempo, the instruments that are played. Atmosphere is the feeling of the music beneath the music. So let's say I want you to imagine the feeling of music by Beyoncé without actually turning on her music or even having a specific song in mind. Depending on how familiar you are with her music, you might immediately recall a feeling that you associate with that music. That right there is atmosphere. Of course, atmosphere is not just limited to music, but can also reside in a place, idea, color, state of being, time or event, genre, style, and more. There is an atmosphere to a child's birthday party, for example, and this atmosphere is completely different from a frat party. It isn't just the tangible differences between the two events, alcohol instead of punch, beer pong instead of pin the tail on the donkey. There's a completely different feeling to those events that is separate from the tangible surroundings, people, and objects that the event comprises. Now let's briefly go into how the atmosphere works for the actor. Basically, Chekhov describes this as the four stages of the creative process. Using their imagination, the actor both receives and supplies the atmosphere of the scene. The atmosphere, in turn, affects the actor and is incorporated into the character's being, which is then sent out or radiated from the character. The actor is then inspired to internal action, truthful emotions and feelings, and external action, physical action and objective. This isn't happening in a sequence of events, but is all happening simultaneously throughout the performance. To sum up, by developing and using their imagination, action to create and receive atmosphere, the actor is able to create a constant source of inspiration, which allows for exciting, truthful, and surprising choices on stage and in film. It also creates a feeling of the ensemble between actor and actor, a feeling of the whole between the actors and the space, and a feeling of interconnectivity between the art and the audience. A strong atmosphere is the player film's living soul, and as such is the difference between a piece of art that is alive and vibrant and a piece of deadly theater that can only offer cliche and banality. Next time, I will be talking more about atmosphere and how the actor can use it. So if you want to be the first to be notified when that video comes out, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell. See you later, colleagues.